Imagine having the entire internet available at the blink of an eye, with a computer monitor on your contact lens. It's already more science than fiction.
You may be walking through a street and you see a restaurant and you'd like to have more information about this restaurant. That can be displayed in front of your eyes. You can imagine a number of different things. A personal GPS type thing that would show you directions to your destination. That information can be superimposed to what you would normally see.
At the University of Washington, a research team has set its sights on creating a real bionic eye. The challenge? Build a screen as small as your iris and figure out how to wirelessly connect it to a computer you put in your pocket.
It's a very complicated device to make because we have to incorporate high-performance circuitry on a contact lens. We have to put small radios on the contact lens to be able to communicate with this device, send data to the lens, perhaps get some data back.
They start by boiling up some lead-free solder to 250 degrees Fahrenheit. Into that, they dip a small polymer wafer that has a tiny circuit board etched onto one side of it.
So once these small components are assembled, we coat everything in a biocompatible polymer and mold the substrate into the right shape to make a contact lens.
To test it, the team tries sending a radio signal to a prototype lens that holds a single pixel.
So what we're trying to do is demonstrate a one-pixel display that's wirelessly powered. So we have an RF transmitter that's transmitting power and data over to a small silicon chip on a contact lens.
And we have contact. The lens picks up the signal and lights up the pixel.
That was wonderful. You'd see that all the hard work has finally paid off, so we're all ecstatic.
So what if we take it to the next step? What if there are lots of pixels to spell out words and make pictures?
Yo, Nicole, how you doing?
Hi, how
How's Brooklyn
are you?
Treating you? Great to see you too. Your dog okay?
Fine.
I saw some really cool pictures. Keep it up, keep it up. Yo, Alana, hey. I haven't seen you since South By in Austin.
I know.
How's the video blogging stuff going?
It's actually starting out like
good. Yeah. Rock it out. I'm gonna check out that latest episode. That's really nice. That's really nice. Desi,
hey.
What's up? And I heard you're finally getting out of Jersey, going to D.C.
Definitely, man.
Treasury Department, right?
Yeah, your hometown, dude.
See, I don't trust you with my money, but congratulations anyway. You know what I mean? Congratulations.
Good to see you.
But hold up a minute. Before we get too carried away with this Terminator vision, when we last left Babak and his team, they had only managed to put one measly pixel on a lens. That's like staring at a flashlight compared to a TV screen. This idea is gonna need some work.
The first pixel was definitely the most difficult. So going from 1 to 10 is going to be a lot easier than going from 0 to 1. And I think it would get definitely easier and easier, probably up to a point, and then again get more difficult as we get to extremely small dimensions.
It would take about a million pixels to create the images we want, and you can't do that by hand. So, Babak's gang dreamed up a shortcut. It's a technique called self-assembly. They make a liquid containing thousands of free-floating pixels. Then they sandwich a circuit board between two pieces of glass. When they pour the liquid into the sandwich, the pixels stick to the metal on the circuit board. With a breakthrough or two, a real bionic lens could be on the market. Then, you'll never be blown off by someone you're sure you know. You'll get instant info or quick reminders on everyone you meet. You'll never have to wonder who they are or what they're like.